Hi everyone, it is Koto. In this video, I'm going to show you how I made this doll for the Under the Sea Web. My secret partner was Sarah from the Sugar Lamp gift shop. She asked a jellyfish-inspired doll from me. To this project, I used Laguna Fire from the Freaky Fusion edition. Before the reroute, I remove her original hair with the help of a screwdriver and a plier. I also remove the paint from her head because I want to use white hair at the reroute. To the reroute, I use the Arctic Fox nylon hair from Retro Dolls. I am working slowly and I am putting hair in every existing holes. Meanwhile, I can watch a movie or a TV show. She will have short hair, but I am adding some longer wefts as well. At the end of the rooting process, I am braiding these longer wefts so her head will look like a little jellyfish. The next step is painting her face. I am using watercolor pencils to draw her eyes and pastels to blush her face and her body. I am drawing her eyebrows by using watercolor pencils. I am always using my pencils dry. I am adding some white and golden dots to decorate her face. I will also decorate her body by adding seashells to it. The first step is creating a base for the shells. To do this, I am using epoxy clay. I am using the end of a smaller brush to create a texture which is similar to her original body. Fire had tails which I removed. To hide the remaining hole, I put a bigger seashell here. After the epoxy clay has dried, I need to paint the shells. To do this, I am using white and golden paint. I will also put some paint to the body, and I am trying to create a beautiful transition. Unfortunately, I couldn't record the end of the painting progress, but you can watch similar painting in my Golden Snail Creature video. Now let's see how the finished doll is looking like.